Hi guys, this is Apoorva here and today I've come up with another interesting topic that is on sugars. So let's understand what are sugars, how dangerous it is for our body or how useful it is for our body. Let's go into the topic in detail and try to understand about these sugars. Now when I'm talking about sugars, I'm not talking about the white color or the brown color sugars, what you take in your teas, coffees, add it in your sweets or so. I am in generally talking about the sugars. Those are nothing but the glucose and fructose. Now, and there are even various other forms of sugars also. Now, let's just understand about the glucose here. Now, the glucose which is there, that is one form of the sugar which is usually formed, it is found in the starchy foods, which is found in sugars as such, milk and milk products and fruits. Now, glucose being the primary source of energy, when the glucose enters into the bloodstream, once you take in the food, the glucose, it enters into the bloodstream. And once it enters into the bloodstream, the pancreas, which is here in green color, it releases the insulin. Now, whatever the body is performing, involuntary or the voluntary function, it needs energy. Now, as I have already told you, glucose is the primary source of energy for all our body functions. Either it may be voluntary or involuntary. Now, for the metabolism to happen, the cells have to be active. Our body is made up of numerous number of cells, and each cell needs energy to perform various kind of functions in our body. Now, for this, the glucose cannot enter into the cell directly and release the energy. For this, it needs insulin. Now, as I've already told you, the pancreas, once the glucose enters into the bloodstream, pancreas automatically releases the insulin. Now, this glucose along with the insulin tries to enter. Now, this insulin acts as a key for the cells for the glucose to enter into the cells. Now this the insulin acts as a key, and then it opens the lock of the cell and the glucose enter into the cells. Now this glucose try to perform the various, it releases, it gives the energy and it performs the various, it helps in performing the various kinds of functions in our body. Now, we'll have obviously excess glucose in our body. What happens is, even there is little more excess glucose, the again cells in the presence of insulin tries to go enter into the cells and releases the energy and performs the function. But if you are taking high amounts of carbohydrates, what happens? Now, here, as I've told you, the liver tries to store the excess amount of carbohydrates or the fats, whatever you're taking in the form of glycogen and fatty acids. Now, the glycogen, whenever you need the energy, for excess energy, you're doing more kind of workouts in a day, or you're doing any kind of strenuous exercises, or you're doing any kind of extra works, the glycogen here tries to get converted into glucose and it gets metabolized and releases the energy. Now what happens with the fat here? Fat also gets utilized, but still, if you're taking the higher amounts of carbohydrates or fat, the fat gets stored in the liver, and this excess fat in the liver leads to fatty liver, which is one of the very common problem which nowadays you can see in everyone. So try to limit your food intake which is containing high amounts of carbohydrates and high amounts of fat, so that the liver doesn't store these excess things in it, and it doesn't result in any kind of problems. Now the diabetes also is caused due to the high amounts of glucose intake or the sugar intake. Now, you know, how much ever the glucose you are taking in, the insulin releases equally and tries to make sure that the glucose enter into the cells and perform the various activities. But when you are taking higher amounts of glucose, the insulin also becomes resistant, and that also leads to the insulin resistant diabetes. And with all these higher amount of fat storage in your body, high sugar intake, this all also leads to the cardiovascular disease. So guys, I hope you have understood how danger the sugars are. You have obviously some benefits, you know, whatever the metabolism, the voluntary or involuntary activities you perform, the glucose is really required. Some amount of carbohydrate is really required. You don't need to go with a zero carbohydrate diet, but you have to have some amount of carbohydrate in your daily diet. But make sure that you do not take high amounts of carbohydrate. And as I have already discussed in my previous video on carbohydrate, you can just go through that video. You will understand what are good carbs and what are bad carbs. Try to take the good carbs in your diet so that at least you would, you know, that kind of good carbs will be helping in the performing of the various activities in your body, rather than storing and causing the various problems like diabetes, fatty liver and cardiovascular diseases. Thank you so much guys for watching my video. Please don't forget to like my video if you like it, share and subscribe to my channel Apoorva Dietitian, and stay tuned to my channel. I will come back next Wednesday with my other new video. Thanks for watching my video. Bye.